we have an ant on a road, initially at position 0. Each second, it crawls to the right by 1 unit. It wants to reach the end of the road, but to its surprise, there are a series of portals in its path. At any given time, an entrance can be either open or closed. Each portal has a unique entrance point and exit point, with the exit always being to the left. When our ant walks into an open entrance, it instantly teleports to the corresponding exit and closes the entrance. When the ant crosses a closed entrance, it continues without interruption, opening the entrance as it passes. In other words, whenever the ant reaches an entrance, it gets toggled on or off. The scenario I've just described to you is the setup to a problem on Codeforces, a competitive programming website. Our goal is to write a program that computes the total time in seconds for our ant to pass the rightmost and final entrance, given an initial configuration of the open and closed states. First, let's take a moment to digest that whole problem. For a small road, we can manually simulate the entire process, tracking the time as we go. That's not so hard. However, consider a road 1 billion units long, with hundreds of thousands of portals. The ant would take literal ages, and so would our simulation. At first glance, it seems like there are just a ton of complicated moving parts, and I won't fault you for that. I had absolutely no idea where to start when I first came across this problem. In these kinds of situations, the only thing we can really do is grab an example and start playing around and picking it apart. There aren't any super obvious footholds here yet, so let's just try to look for any sort of trends to latch onto. See if a pattern jumps out at you. Maybe you've already spotted it. Look at the portals positioned left of the ant at any given time. It sure looks like they're always open. While it's difficult to see the immediate value of this fact, noticing any sort of pattern here is still useful in building intuition for the problem. So let's try to explore this observation a little more. Some obvious questions then. Why is this true, and can we prove it? Well, at the beginning, it's trivially true. There aren't any portals behind us. Let's see if the property still holds as we walk across new portals. Let's assume that all of the portals behind us are open. If we cross a closed portal, it opens up behind us, and the property is still true. Everything behind us is still open. If we instead cross an open portal, it sends us backwards to the left. Since the entrances to the left of us were already open, and we've only moved leftwards, the property is still true. With a little bit of casework, we've managed to develop an inductive proof for this observation. Now, how does it help us? At first, it seemed like the configuration of portals in our path could be arbitrary. With this observation, we at least know that the state of the portals behind us is consistent and predictable. We can count on the fact that they're always going to be open as long as they're positioned to the left of us. Because the state of the portals behind us is fixed, every time we enter a certain portal, we follow the exact same path to reach the portal again. This means that the time taken to traverse the portals behind a given entrance will be the same every time. This is a massive simplification of the original problem, and is key to our eventual solution. In a problem like this, where we find ourselves repeating the same computation over and over, we can use a handy concept called dynamic programming to speed up the solution. If we can store the results of our prior computations in a clever way, we can then reuse them later to quickly produce new results as needed. Do you see a way that dynamic programming could be used to simplify this problem? To make illustrating our solution a bit easier, let's formalize our approach. Let x, y, and s be integer arrays of length n, where n is the number of portals. X of I represents the position of the entrance to the ith portal, Y sub I is the exit position, and S of I is the initial state. Now, consider tracking the time it takes to return back to a portal entrance after entering it. We've established that these return trips will always cost the same amount of time, since they always take the same path. Let's add another array DP, where DP of I represents the return trip time for portal I. Take a moment to convince yourself that if we have successfully computed DP, we can easily obtain the answer by adding up the DP values for all portals whose initial state is open. So then the question is, how do we actually calculate the DP array? We know we'll at least have to travel the gap between our exit and our entrance, so let's set that aside. Let's see if we can compute the time of a return trip based on previously computed times. When making a return trip, we will encounter all of the portals between our exit and our entrance, with each one making its own return trip along the way. This leads us to a pivotal conclusion. The time it takes to enter a portal and return back to the same position is simply the distance between the ends plus the sum of the return trip times of all of the portals caught in between. Graphically, we can now tell that DP of I is equal to the distance between the exit and the entrance, which is X of I minus Y sub I, plus the sum of all of the DP values contained in our range. The cool part is, since these portals all came before us, we already have their DP values. Whenever we compute DPI, all of the DP values we depend on have already been solved for in previous iterations. For a naive solution, we can manually add up the DP values in the range one by one to compute each new DP value. Since we're potentially looping across all previous values to compute each new value of DP, this yields us a time complexity of O of n squared, meaning that, in general, our algorithm will run in time for smaller inputs up to around n equals 5000. So that's great, we actually have a working solution in a reasonable time complexity. It's not quite fast enough to pass the problem under the original constraints yet, but take a minute to convince yourself that you understand why it actually works. It's pretty tricky. As a recap, we first observed that whenever you reach a portal, it's guaranteed that all of the portals behind you are active. We then use this fact to show that the return trip time for an open entrance can be expressed as the distance between the two ends of the portal plus the sum of all of the return trip times for the portals caught in between. Now, let's get to optimizing. Much of the inefficiency and redundancy in our current approach is in calculating the sums of the DP values. We want to be able to compute the sum of all of those return trip times quickly, so we need to come up with a better approach than just adding them up one by one. Perhaps you've already guessed it by now. Since we're dealing with sums of ranges, we probably want to be applying the prefix sum technique. This will allow us to compute the sum of a contiguous range of numbers in a blistering O of 1 time, with a linear O of n precomputation. For a brief explanation of prefix sums, imagine we have an array of random numbers and we want to ask for the sum of a particular range L to R. If we have a huge number of these queries, it's not scalable to sum the values one by one each time. Instead, let's make a new array PS, storing the running sum at each position. In other words, PS of I represents the sum of the first I numbers. Then, to query the sum of a particular range, we can just take the running sum or the prefix sum up to R and subtract it from the prefix sum of the element right before L. The resulting difference is the new amount that was added between positions L and R. However, that doesn't actually fully solve our problem. How can we find out the correct range to plug into our prefix sum? To solve our new problem, we can apply a simple yet surprisingly powerful classic algorithm, binary search. Since we're processing the portals in ascending order of entrance position, and we know the coordinates of our exit, we can binary search the entrances for the index j of the leftmost portal that would be included in our range. Then, using prefix sums, we can find the sum of all the DP values in that range in O of 1. This yields a total time complexity of O of n log n, which is absolutely fast enough to pass the constraints, and is a pretty natural extension of the O of n squared algorithm. I really encourage you to digest the solution for a bit, make sure you really understand how it works. Then, try to implement it yourself and maybe submit it to the grader on Codeforces. With all of that convoluted explanation out of the way, let's take a minute to appreciate and visualize the algorithm that we've built together, and watch it tear the problem apart in n log n time. If you learned something or enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. A lot of work went into this project, and hopefully I'll be able to continue it with your support.